So at which type? Okay, so at which side we have to inject the voltage? So in that one, so we have to and the two types. One is the midpoint of segment type. Okay, one is the midpoint, another is the end of the line. So we have to inject the voltage, right? So whatever the last voltage, okay, that you have to inject in the transmission line. So in the transmission line, how we have to inject? Okay, that you have done by using the here two types. One is the end of the line. Okay, here what we are doing, so one having the end of the line, another having the midpoint. That means, so we are going to inject the voltage in the transmission line, that is midpoint. Okay, so one is the midpoint, another one is having the end of the line. That is, so whatever the losses we get at the end side, okay, before that, so we are going to inject the voltage. That is, so we are getting the voltage, okay, so rated voltage will get the end side. So here this is the diagram. So this is the diagram for the midpoint voltage. Okay. So here we're having, so we're having the two bus. So we're having the lights. Okay. So VS is the sending voltage, VR is the receiving end. Okay. In between we're having, so the X by 2, X by 2 is nothing but here the, they are the impedance of the line. Okay. So here the voltage. Okay. So the shunt compensation voltage. Okay. So I hope you are seeing the diagram. That is a midpoint voltage, I think. Okay, if not it, please open your chapter. Okay, third chapter notes. Okay, please go through the first paper. That is a midpoint voltage regulation. So in that one, we are having the diagram, right? So in the diagram, so we are having the two generators. Okay, so in between having the two machines, the two bus bars will there. And between having the midpoint, okay, so that is a wear compensator. So that the midpoint is that is a compensator. So midpoint we are getting injecting the voltage. Okay, that is a ideal compensator. So that in between, so whatever the lines is there. So you are seeing lines, right? So here these lines. Okay, let me unlight. So here, so this is the one source. Here is the another source. So in the source, what we are doing? So this is the these are the transmission. So the X by 2 are the impedance of the lines. Okay, so in impedance, and here's the midpoint. So this is the wear compensator. So this wear compensator, what we are in. So we are injecting the voltage. Okay, from the midpoint. So we are taking the reference. Okay, so we are taking the reference. That is a, how much input is there. Okay, that is a, this, how much voltage we are getting from the between the sending end and receiving end. So we are checking the both sides. Okay, how much voltage we are having. So voltage variation. So how much voltage we are getting, how much voltage we are sending. Okay, receiving and sending voltage we are first we are taking inputs. Then, so how much variations is it? Okay, how much error in between the two voltages. That is the input voltage, how we are having the sending end. So how much sending end voltage we are having and how much receiving end voltage we have. Okay, that we have to consider. So based upon the two inputs, so we have to inject the voltage. Okay, so the, how much variations? Suppose if the 10% variation, okay, so normal it will not happen. If we consider 3% variation is there. Okay, so due to the load, okay, at the load side what happened, due to the no load condition what happened, so we're getting the less voltage. If the full load conditions what happened, we're getting the more voltage. So if light load condition what we are getting, so we are getting the less voltage drop. So if we continuously drop is take places. Okay, so let me, so here right, so this is the sending, here is the considering receiving. So in between light, right? So here we are having, if the sending and receiving end, okay, so light load condition what will happen, so less voltage drop will be there. Okay, so less voltage drops. So if the load is connected, okay, so if the load is connected, the full load, what will happen, it will, the voltage drops will be high. So at this condition what happen, so if we fix the same voltage drop, okay, so here what we are going to do, that is, so here wear compensator. So this wear compensator what will do, so it will be check the both voltage, that is input voltage, that is sending end voltage, receiving end voltage. So by this taking, okay, they will take the inputs of the this one, and so how much voltage drop is there? Okay, so based on the both inputs, how much voltage drop? Okay, that will be calculated. Okay, and the how much voltage drop, okay, that will be injected, okay, that will be injected both, okay, that will be injected by using this compensator. So it will be inject the voltage in the line, okay. So if it is the based upon that is in the line, okay, what the transmission is there. So in the line, what happens? So the continuously varies is there, okay. So based upon the inputs, okay, the based upon input only, it will be. That is, if the light load condition, so less amount of inject the voltage. If the heavy load condition, so we'll get the high voltage drop. So to avoid the voltage drop, so we have to get inject the high amount of voltage in the line. Okay, that will be done using the wire compensator. Okay, so this compensate voltage, it will be take the both wires, that is input and output. So here is the impedance. So impedance also is one thing. So we have to consider the impedance. The impedance is that impedance will be varies. Okay, so based depend upon the transmission line. Okay, either it will be connected long transmission, short transmission line, or conductor size, atmosphere conditions. Okay, it will also vary. So if the impedance is vary, the voltage drops. Okay, that we also consider. Okay, so we have to consider the impedance. Okay, impedance what are the of the line. Okay, so if we they consider the here what we are doing. So we are taking the one midpoint. At the midpoint only we are connect the compensator. That is, so at the both sides we'll get inject the voltage equal. Okay, by that one we can reduce the impedance. So if we low impedance, high efficiency. Okay, so then we can get the high efficiency. Right? So if you understand this concept,